amusement park and airports of Canada? And for today, our pilot is Sonal and co-pilot is Indrani. So let's get started. Over to you, Sonal.
Thank you, Shruti. So good evening, guests. I hope you all are doing great. We have come across Canada's capital flag, culture, airlines, climate, but now we'll be exploring the airports, amusement parks and zoos the country has. Canada, second largest country in the world in area after Russia, occupying roughly the northern two-fifths of the continent of North America. Despite Canada's great size, it is one of the world's most sparsely populated countries. Canada is officially bilingual in English and French, reflecting the country's history as ground once contested by two of Europe's great powers. Now, moving forward, let us explore the airports in Canada. Vancouver International Airport. This airport is located on Sea Island in Richmond, British Columbia. Vancouver International is among the top-rated airports in Canada for its superior decor features and unmatched facilities. The airport features the world's largest living wall with thousands of green plants along with a solar-powered water heating system. Now, what are the features the airport has? It has huge aquarium with more than 5,000 marine creatures and a special aquarium dedicated to jellyfish. Number second, the Toronto Pearson International Airport. This is the busiest and largest airport in Canada, which covers entire Toronto metropolitan region and the Golden Horseshoe area around it. Not only it is the biggest airport in Canada, but it is aesthetically beautiful, very spacious and well-managed. The world-class modern and clean airport is not just a gateway to North America, but also a cultural hub with its permanent art collection and rotating art exhibits. The permanent collection includes 8 exhibits created by artists from across the world. The special features of this airport is stylish, well-equipped and comfortable premium plaza lounges, the two dinosaur models of Allosaurus and Othniella relic. Number third, Halifax Stanfield International Airport. Serving not just Halifax and mainland Nova Scotia, this frequently awarded airport also serves as an important hub for passengers flying in and out of the nearby maritime provinces. There are decent food options and nice shops to pick reasonably priced souvenirs. The special features of the airport are airport tours on specific days of the week, superb seafood store for picking up local seafood for your travel. Number four, Montreal Pearson Trudeau International Airport. This is counted amongst the busiest airport in Canada. This spacious and modern place is dotted with wonderful restaurants, food joints, bars, and duty-free shops to keep you occupied while you wait there. There are 2 Tim Hortons along with numerous French cafes for some great coffee and quick bites. The special features of the airport is Brûlerie Saint-Denis is great for imported coffee beans and a variety of Arabica coffee. Number 5, Ottawa McDonnell Cartier International Airport. This airport is named after the 2 founding fathers of Canada. This small but efficient airport serving the Ottawa region is well surfaced and easy to navigate. The check-in and security is usually hassle-free and quick. The special features of the airport is very impressive fountain across gate 17, reflexology and manicure treatments available. Now we'll be visiting one of the airports. Indrani.
Yeah, make me host.
Yes. Oh. It is sprawled over 710 acres in the beautiful Rock Valley. This is the biggest zoo in Canada with over 5,000 animals from 450 plus species. The well-planned and maintained zoo has been thoughtfully divided into seven zoo geographical regions, showcasing animals from various continents in their natural habitats. With 6 miles of walking trails, a discovery zone with interactive wildlife experience, fun splash island, and some thrilling animal themed rides for your little wildlife explorers, the zoo offers a memorable experience that's educational as well as entertaining. What are the things that you shouldn't miss when you visit there? The special Great Barrier Reef and Tundra Track exhibits, waterside theater, and animal keeper talks and feedings to get up close and personal with your favorite animals. Second one is Calgary Zoo. It is located on the lovely St. George Island on the Bow River. The Calgary Zoo, one of the best spots in the city. With over 100 unique species of animals and myriad interesting engagement activities and events, this one is a gem amongst the numerous Canada zoo and aquariums. From the Canadian wild section, this is home to bears, wolves, and whooping cranes, to the thrilling destination Africa and fun lands of lemurs. There are so many fascinating habitats, animals, and birds to keep you occupied throughout the day. What are the things you shouldn't miss here? The fascinating new panda passage featuring the giant panda, safari brunch on Sunday mornings, and the luminous zoo lights during Christmas time. Third is Edmonton Valley Zoo. It is one of the best zoos in Canada, offering fun and education for the entire family. The Edmonton Valley Zoo is home to more than 350 native and exotic animals representing 100 different species. This small zoo, focused on animal conservation, aims to provide an intimate experience to the visitors with engaging animal interaction programs. Located on the banks of North Saskatchewan River, the lovely zoo is divided into various habitats, including the Arctic shores with harbor seals, fur seals, and Arctic ground squirrels. The red pandas and Asian elephant Lucy are the biggest attractions. The things which you shouldn't miss here: the new entry plaza with the otters and state-of-the-art education facility, the wonder trail along the river with native flora and fauna. Number fourth is Magnetic Hill Zoo. This modern and family-friendly zoo boasts of an interesting lineup of 600 plus indigenous and exotic animals from Asia, Africa, and Americas, as well as Discovery Center. With its focus on protection of animal species, public awareness, and education about the different habitats, Magnetic Hill Zoo is home to emu tigers, lemurs from Madagascar, gibbon apes, and many more animals. Being the largest zoo in Atlantic Canada, it has fantastic displays, petting and feeding areas, as well as special camps and events for children all year round. Things you shouldn't miss here: Who at the Zoo, which is held in October, Wild Lights, which is held between the months of December to January, and Zookeeper program for kids. Number fifth is Assiniboine Park Zoo. This zoo is spread over 80 acres, which is one of the largest and most impressive zoos in Canada, with over 200 fabulous animal and bird species from across the world. In operation for more than a century, the fantastic zoo is open all year round with many indoor and outdoor exhibits, allowing you to admire and interact with the amazing animals. From the reindeers to red fox, gray wolves, American elk, harbor seals, and the hugely popular polar bears, the zoo has an invaluable range of exotic animals. The Australian walkabout, Animals of Asia, and Butterfly Garden exhibits are great for the entire family. The places which you shouldn't miss here: Kinsman Discovery Center award-winning journey to Churchill exhibit that takes visitor on an unforgettable adventure to the land of polar bears. Now let's see a video of one of the zoos. Indrani, take over. Moving towards the amusement parks. First one is Callaway Park, which is in Calgary. It is Western Canada's largest outdoor family amusement park, boasting 32 rides, 24 eateries, 23 shows. The park is only fun, and it is our mission. It's backed up by the fact that the park receives 500,000 visitors per season.
The voice is not clear.
Mom, we can't yes. hear you.
Ma'am is disconnected.
For me. Okay, okay, we are looking for it. So by the time, who's gonna tell me what is the largest animal in the world?
The blue whale.
The,
yes.
Blue whale. Incorrect.
Ma'am, blue whale.
Okay, so do you
the
guys
animal
know?
Animal is the elephant, the African elephant, and the fish is the blue whale.
Yes.
Neither of these two are the biggest. On land, elephant, the African elephant might be, but the blue whale isn't the biggest. There are some species of dinosaurs that grew up to 101 feet, 10 feet longer than the blue whale.
No, but she's talking about modern day animals.
Animals include all types of animals. Even dinosaurs are animals.
Yes, but they don't exist anymore. So I was talking about the existing animals. Okay, so I was talking about the blue whale. So I must tell you that the biggest blue whale you can find in the Canadian water. So this is moreover found in Canada, and they grew up to 27 meter long. And they weigh even 132 tons. So more number of blue whales you will find in Canada Sea. Okay, so any one of you has know any other fact about animals of Canada? Is there anyone? Okay, so have you looked about the amusement parks in Canada? Can you name some? Okay, so who's going to tell me the first country which we have visited during this event?
I'm India.
India.
Yeah, Australia.
India.
Yes, we began the India, our country India. And then the next day we had
Australia, then Austria, Bangladesh, Belgium, Brazil, and now Canada.
Yes. And for tomorrow we will be visiting China.
China.
Yes. Okay, so we have a presentation for you.
Sorry, guys, for the inconvenience caused. So the first one is Callaway Park, Calgary. It is Western Canada's largest outdoor family amusement park, boasting 32 rides, 24 eateries, 23 games, live entertainment shows, and its 3D theater. There is certainly something for every member of your family. The park is all about family fun, and its motto, Your Smile is Our Mission, which is backed up by the fact that the park receives over 500,000 visitors per season. The ride you need to go on are Timber Falls, it is one not to miss. The log flume splashes down 3 high velocity drops as well as a wild zigzagging river. The next one is Galaxy Land, which is in Edmonton. It is located in West Edmonton Mall. Is the world's largest indoor amusement park with more than 27 exciting rides, attractions, and play areas for all ages. The space theme park is home to Mind Blender, the largest indoor triple loop roller coaster in the world, as well as four-story indoor jungle gym. Galaxyland, which opened back in 1995, is regarded as one of the Canada's top parks and boasts a number of guest resorts. An added bonus is that park is it is open 365 days a year. Ride you need to go on are Mindbender, as well as three vertical loop. The coaster has twisting drops and a dizzying helix. Canada's Wonderland, which is in Vaughan, Ontario, it is country's largest theme park, stretching over 330 acres, and it is one of the most visited parks in the whole North of America. The park is home to over 200 attractions, 69 rides, and 15 roller coasters. And if the weather is hot, the 20-acre Splash Works water park will help you cool off. The Flying Eagles ride is aimed at smaller children, and these two-person planes glide 28 feet above the ground as little pilots control their flight and a ride experience. Ride you need to go on are Leviathan is arguably the biggest and scariest roller coaster on the block and will certainly test your nerve. Last one is La Ronde, which is in Montreal. It is the biggest theme park in Eastern Canada, sitting on 146 acres on the tip of St. Helens Island, just a stone throw away from the picturesque Old Port in Montreal. The Six Flags Park has over 40 rides and attractions to delight visitors and offers 10 roller coasters for thrill seekers to brave. Even the most fearless theme park goers might get shaky knees on La Ronde's Goliath, one of the tallest and faster roller coasters in Canada. Other gut-wrenching rides you can dare include Boomerang, which shoots you down a trio of high-speed loops and then boomerangs you upwards to the start. On Cobra, a roller coaster that will satisfy your need for speed. Ride you need to go on are, although the Goliath roller coaster is a great choice, we recommend going on La Monster, which is tallest two-track wooden coaster in the world. Indrani, take over now.
Yes.
Ma'am, it was feeling like we would have flown into the air.
That's great. I hope you all like the video and thank you for being a patient viewers. Thank you all.
Okay, so for now, that was the tour to Canada. And tomorrow we will be visiting China. And we will be talking about all the airports, zoos, and the amusement parks of the China. So, do you guys have any information of the wildlife of China?
Ma'am, wildlife bacha hi kahan hai? Sab kha pi ke khatam kar diya hai.
Oh yeah, that's also the thing. Like they eat everything they like.
They eat bat, and it was considered that corona had started from the eating the bats only, right?
Yeah, people just talk like this. Yeah.
Ma'am.
Okay, so what's the capital of China? Yes, Abhi?
Ma'am, capital of China is Beijing.
Beijing.
Yes. Okay, so Abhi wanted to say something.
There are 15 elephants in China just migrating, searching for food for 1 year.
All right. Thanks for sharing. Any other fact you know about this place?
I know that apples are consumed a lot in China.
I know that Chinese people will survive in the wild for the longest. They can eat anything there.
Yes. Okay. Okay, anyone else?
They use yuan as the currency, and they speak Chinese there. Mandarin.
Okay.
They make a bird's nest soup in China.
Okay. So, do you all like Chinese food?
I love Chinese food. There is only chow mein for us.
Okay.
I hate China. China only made coronavirus.
Yeah.
Don't blame the country, blame the person.
Okay, so we won't talk about the negative things of the place, right? So we'll just talk about the airports, zoos, and the amusement park.
Okay,
so so that was all about our today's tour. Tomorrow we will visit a new place, China. So see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.